Hi, I'm Diana Scothorn, founder of the Benefit Link, once again here to talk to you about Medicare. Woohoo! Sounds exciting, doesn't it? But today we're going to talk about a subject that is very close to my heart, that I am very passionate about, and it's people really having an understanding between the difference between Medicare Supplement Insurance and Medicare Advantage plans. They're completely different, and I happen to personally know about both of them because I had a mom who is on both of them, a Medicare supplement and a Medicare Advantage plan. So I can share with you some personal things I know, but more importantly, some professional things that I absolutely can guide you as far as the difference between them both. First, let's just say this. One of the things about Medicare supplements is that it is something where you can be assured that you have total, complete 100% control of your healthcare, meaning you're able to go to any doctor, any hospital, anywhere in the United States, and as long as your doctor takes Medicare, there is nothing you have to go through to make sure you get seen. You just go in there, hand them your card, walk out. There are no hidden things between Medicare and your Medicare supplement. As long as Medicare approves the first dollar, your supplement, depending on the one you have, picks up all the rest of it. So one thing is, Medicare supplements require no referrals, they require no pre-authorization, they require no list of network of doctors or hospitals, and you have the ability, this is a big one, to get on or off a Medicare supplement any time of the year that you want. Now, Medicare Advantage plans look a little bit more appealing on the front end, because for one thing, Medicare supplement insurance is going to cost money. There is a premium. And one of the things that we really want people to understand is that a lot of times there's an illusion that you're not going to have to pay for a Medicare Advantage plan. You hear the commercials that it's free and you may qualify for this and, you know, you may get this and it doesn't cost you anything. Well, I just want everybody to really understand and really think about it, because we've all lived long enough to know nothing is free. And right now, in the middle of a world pandemic, with hospital costs going up, doctors' costs going up, everything going up, it certainly is not free for healthcare as far as insurance. So there definitely are costs involved, and that's what I want you to be aware of. So Medicare Advantage plans, you have referrals, you do have a network of doctors, a network of hospitals, depending on the plan, they're all different. And because they're not standardized by the federal government, each individual company that offers an Advantage plan can make their own guidelines and set their own exclusions and adjust it to what is suitable for their guidelines. Whereas on a Medicare supplement, everything is standardized. Now, I told you that I was going to share with you a few things, and one of them is with my own mother, and my mom was retiring. She was turning 65, and she had rheumatoid arthritis, and the reason she was retiring is because my baby sister, who was only 35 at that time, juvenile diabetic, had had a kidney transplant on Medicare at the age of 23. Very unexpectedly, the day before Mother's Day, everything just quit. Her organs quit, her heart quit, everything quit, and that was it. You know, just like that, she went on to be with the Lord. Well, my mom was working, and that was a lot of stress, and she also had rheumatoid arthritis, and this was back in year 2000, and the Advantage plans had just came out for the first time ever in year 2000. So nobody in the industry, not even me, it didn't matter how long, I've been here 30 years, it doesn't matter how long you were in the industry, you're thinking, oh, wow, this must be wonderful. It's going to cost her nothing. I didn't know anything about it. She's looking to me for guidance. So I remember telling her, I said, well, Mother, I don't really understand how this is going to work, but I do know this. You're seeing a rheumatologist and you have a doctor that you're not going to want to not have. You need to check and make sure he's still on the network. And so she did, and he was. And so now we know that her doctor is a part of the network, which my thinking, which is probably like your thinking, was, well, if the insurance is not going to cost her anything, and her doctor's on the network, we might as well get it. Now, let me just say what they mean by most of them not costing you anything is that the money that you pay into Social Security that gives you your Part B as in boy, that you have to have in order to have a Medicare supplement. You have to have A and B to get a Medicare supplement. And they take money directly out of your Social Security for your Part B as in boy. That money would no longer go to Medicare, and Social Security wouldn't have it go that direction. It would now go over to this Advantage plan. An Advantage plan of whoever you selected, that money goes there. So now what that does, it knocks you hypothetically off of Medicare, and that's why they call Medicare Advantage plans a Medicare replacement. So now Medicare is replaced by your Advantage plan. Now they are your primary carrier and they are your primary beneficiary, so to speak, of handling your Medicare benefits. So that's one thing. It's not that it's free, it's meaning that it is not going to cost you an additional premium for your Medicare because they're taking over your Medicare benefits. But in the meantime, you are subject to their exclusions and their guidelines. And so Medicare does not coordinate benefits in any shape, fashion, or form with a Medicare Advantage plan. That's a big misconception. Your Medicare, so to speak, is dormant. You still have it, but it's not active as far as playing a role in helping with the charges that you're going to get. Well, back to my mom. My mom, her rheumatologist was on the network, and that's what we decided to do. She was still working, and that was the group insurance that they provided when she turned 65, was this brand new Advantage plan through a carrier that offered her insurance. Well, let me just tell you the moral to this story. My mom had a lot of stress losing my sister. 8 weeks later, my stepfather had a massive heart attack and died. That was her spouse of 20-something, 26 years. So she lost a baby and a husband in 8 weeks. Well, can I tell you that one of the things, and anybody who has RA or rheumatoid arthritis and has ever dealt with it, you know it's stress-induced. Can I tell you, you don't have to have RA to have things in life happen to cause you stress. You can have headaches and backaches and pain just over stress, but when you have rheumatoid arthritis, it really kicks in. It had got so bad, guys, that my mom could no longer type. She couldn't use the computer. She had like a 5.5 ring finger. She couldn't even get a size 11 ring. That's how much inflammation. It just got to the point that she said, I don't know what I'm going to do. Well, her rheumatologist, which was on the network, by the way, in the network, part of the network, said, Ruth, this is what we're going to do. We are going to do what's called Remicade, which is an infusion treatment. And she said, what it's going to do, it's going to retard the arthritis from going any further. It doesn't cure it, but what it's going to do is reduce the inflammation. You'll have quality of life. You'll feel much better. And we're going to do these. Well, this is how it all started. Nope. Insurance company came back. No, it was denied. Well, the doctor didn't understand. I didn't understand. My mom didn't understand. How could it be denied? She's on the network. So the nurses are calling. They're saying there must be a mistake. We're a part of the network. We had three different denials. Finally, I get involved. I'm like, hey, I don't know what's going on, but my mom's in excruciating pain, and her doctor's recommended this. You're on the network. There must be a problem. The person on the other end of the phone with the insurance company, with the HMO, said, yes, we are a part of the network. However, there are exclusions that say we, the insurance company, can determine what we consider to be medically necessary. Medically necessary was life-threatening, meaning my mother's life had to be in danger. She's just had a massive heart attack, or, she was whatever the situation, but they deemed it unnecessary. Bottom line is, my mom could not get treatment. She ended up having to retire. She couldn't work anymore. Because she retired, she had a period where she was guaranteed issue to be able to get insurance. She got a Medicare supplement. And let me just tell y'all something, guys. My mom took those treatments 2 weeks later after her supplement went into effect. She took those treatments for 6 years every 8 weeks. after the first treatment, within 3 days, her inflammation had gone from an 11 and a half size finger down where she could get a size 7 ring on. She was back to her normal duties within, like when I say duties, she could mow the lawn and do dishes and clean the house and do whatever she needed. She had her quality of life back. There is limitations with these plans that are detrimental. That was over 20 years ago. Since then, fast forward, we just had an article came out April 28th by a source that goes through, I actually wrote it down here, Department of the Human Services for Medicare, that came out where the government is getting all involved in this because we have had like $1.7 million in claims just recently been denied. They're having people that are going in, they can't get referrals to get CAT scans for 5 and 6 weeks, and this is to determine their cancer growth. There is just a lot of things that people do not understand about these plans. Now, here's the thing. Bottom line, when people say, you know what, I just can't afford it. My mother said the same thing. She's like, do you think I can afford it? Here's the thing. It is not free. If you're having to pay 20% of chemo and 20% of medical durable and 20% of oxygen, or more importantly, guys, you can't even get in. I'll just say one other thing, and then you guys can call the benefit link. We can kind of guide you through a little bit more, but I just had somebody call me just a few weeks ago. Her mother has always had a Medicare supplement, always. Her mother's 84, has always had 100% coverage. She takes the daughter, takes the mother to all her doctor's appointments because her eyesight is not well enough now to drive. She's never had a problem with it. End of last year, her mother, which she did not know, her mother lives alone, entertained a phone call, ended up getting on a Medicare Advantage plan. And what happened was, of course, she got knocked off of Medicare. And January 1, she was going to have this Advantage plan. In the meantime, in December, the mom got diagnosed with lymphoma cancer. The daughter immediately makes an appointment to see a specialist. It was close to Christmas. They couldn't go till after the first of the year. They go immediately to the specialist. They get in. Specialist won't take her. They won't see her. The daughter said, there must be some kind of problem here. My mom can go to any doctor. And they said, well, it looks like your mother has changed plans. That's when it all started. Mother, have you done something that I didn't know about? Well, they wouldn't see her. They sent her home. They said, you need to get a referral. This just happened, guys. The daughter calls to get a referral. She waits 32 days. The nearest referral she could get was 52 miles. Now keep in mind, lymphoma cancer, not something you want to wait 30 days. Now, even if she starts the treatment, this is an hour back and forth all the time. I mean, it was just not a good situation. Gets to the doctor's office. They come out and said, we can't see you. The daughter's very upset, and she said, wait a minute. We just waited over 30 days to get a referral. You know what they told her? We are so sorry. We completely understand. Yes, you have the referral. Yes, we can see you, but we still haven't had the authorization released to be able to start the treatment. They sent her home again. These are things that you don't want. You want to know, God forbid, I hope you never need it, but in the event you ever do need any kind of health care, I think peace of mind is very important, that you're able to go to any doctor, any hospital, anywhere in the United States. Now, I will say this, just so you guys know, that you know, one of the things with the Medicare Advantage plan, you do have your drug plan that is included in that Advantage plan, okay? Now, the reason being is because if you are getting knocked off of Medicare, you cannot have a Medicare Part D drug plan through Medicare. The insurance company, the Advantage plan, has got to provide that in there. So typically, if you have a cost, and the average, you know, let's say it's $25, $30, $50 for your Advantage plan, that is because the average drug plan ranges between $35 and $55. So here's my recommendation. You have to do what you feel like is going to give you the most peace of mind. But to me, peace of mind comes from freedom of knowing you can go anywhere you need, whoever you love can go anywhere they need, and please know that we are here because we're passionate about making sure you get good coverage. So, hope this helps. I hope that you are in a position where you understand that your health care is the number one most important thing in these years and in this season of your life. God bless you. We're passionate about serving you. We look forward to meeting you and talking with you and helping you. Until then, Diana Scothorn with the Benefit Link.